She was inviting me to follow her. Come, come see, she was telling me. It was her best part. The victim who plays her role to cheat death. But she wasn't deceiving anyone. And me, even less. Conscientious diva, Selena walked to her grand finale. My fear was washed away by disgust. I was about to meet William. Me. And I had killed her. I had killed the only beautiful thing in the world. The only one which could save me. I'm sorry. It was me all along, Selena. The son of a bitch. The sicko. The killer. The wolf. The filth. The bastard. The scum. Oh, you should have let your mother kill you. You should have undone what she did. You knew, and yet you let me have a second chance, Selena. Let me go on till the end. The memories of what I had done were coming back slowly, like the tide washing ashore the rotten corpses from a wreck. Selena was lighter than a pillow. The real weight was all those years of filth stored in my memory. Images. The blade I sunk deep into the stomach of my own mother. Those dark-haired women. Those hated clones of Margaret, split from head to toe as a sacrifice to the moon. Their organs displayed carefully, like some child fresco. Selena on the stage of smoke and mirrors. The glass I used to toast with her. The first time we talked. Her tears. The letters in which she told me about losing her kid. How her husband had been murdered. And our kiss. The blade I used to stab her. My father and the father of my mother died from the same madness. The same poison that men injected into the economic system they had created. On October 29th, 1929, millions of casualties. The scent of blood. and for the wolves, the beginning of the hunt. Selena's warmth was pulsing slowly in my arms as the dark spot of my culpability was growing over her stomach. In the sky, the moon was watching me, her son, as I was taking my first steps, holding her daughter in my arms. A resurrection. A second chance. Selena was dying. I could tell from her body, tightly pressed against me. At times, her eyes would open and stare at me. Not a hint of anger or accusation. She could have let go. Let her light pass. Let my mother take me back. But she was protecting me. She was forgiving me. The moon was silently watching us as we made our last push through the night. Soon, dawn would come. The sun would wash away all that ink which had condemned us. Goodbye, Luna. Goodbye, Mother. This night had been too long already. Went as far as I could. Selena, the one who would give me everything life had left her, was fading away, despite my efforts to hold on to her light. If night was the world, then this world had no end. This was my America. Stranded here, facing the void under the cold glare of the silent moon. She was dying. She was dying for all eternity. And I kept awake to see her take her leave.